I like getting paid. Do you like getting paid? Let's get paid in Softr. In today's video, we're going to dive into the different types of payment options that you have within Softr when it comes to the different blocks where we can accept payments from users. You can set up one-time payments, subscriptions, and memberships either on a monthly or yearly basis within Softr. These can be through credit cards, PayPal, and it's all thanks to the native Stripe integration that we have here at Softr. Even if you have products that are sold on Gumroad, you can integrate those here as well. Your website also has a built-in page where members can view the different payment history that they have. Let's jump right into all of it. So there are multiple different payment blocks within Softr. If you go to add a new block, type payments in, you'll notice that we have the Stripe customer portal, which is the first one. We have a simple billing block, which allows people to see what plan they're on. We have a simple checkout form, which is the most basic sort of thing where literally, I mean, you just pay. This is essentially the point of this whole video, right? You want to get people to pay. The payment block that's most important is the simple checkout form when it comes to just getting people to pay. And then if we want to list the different prices for things, we can set this up here with the pricing plan. And the cool thing about this is we can set it up to showcase the monthly and yearly price in different sections. So we have the three tiers right here. So we have this startup price, for example, you'll see that it's 25 a month. And for yearly price, it's 25. So if we mark that down to 20 in the preview, you'll notice that since it starts at yearly, it goes to $20 a month. If I click monthly, it increases the price. If you don't want it to have multiple billing cycles, you can untick this so it gets rid of that, but totally up to you. And within here, you also can move up and down all these different features. You can change what they say, add more features, adjust this from being a checklist to picking from the library within here. So I could do something like a plus sign. And this can be adjusted for all of the different card tiers. So it's completely customizable. You also can change the size of these icons here as well. You'll see right here, they're getting bigger as I change the size. And you can upload your own image if you want as well. The different pricing blocks are very similar. The only other things I'll say is that this one ends up just showing a single pricing card with text to the side of it. This one just adjusts the size of it from left to right, it gets bigger. And then this one is going to just have a option for images to be on the top. So you'll see here, these images are put in place. You're allowed to change this icon to whatever you want, pick from the library as well, similar to what you had previously with the different feature icons, but overall a very similar block. Diving into the simple checkout form, this allows users to make a purchase. Before you end up setting up this block, make sure that you're already connected with Stripe. So you can go to settings, integrations, and then find Stripe checkout here. All you need to do is copy your Stripe publishable key and secret key here. There is an entire help doc that showcases this process. For security purposes, I'm not gonna go into a Stripe account and show you the actual items, but you can find this in the developer section in the API keys. You can create the secret key and then paste it within here, and then it will be blocked out. And then from there, you can see it's very simple. Someone can put their name, email, and pick how they want to subscribe to it within here. And also clicking on here, you're able to add a coupon and place it in there. So what you can do here is you can select different products. So for example, this enterprise monthly option, you can change the price to whatever you'd like, change the interval, and then put the different discount code information in here. This also will change the preview text of what the discount codes are. You can disable the discount codes if you don't have them. You can adjust whether you want to have a different trial amount of time within here. And for any of these, you just have to change the product to get the price that you want. When you go here, you'll have the option to change what this text is for the subscribe now. By default, it's going to say subscribe now, but you could always put pay now and you'll see what it'll adjust here. And you can set it so that after the payment is done, you can go to whatever page you feel like. Now, when it comes to the simple billing block, the Stripe customer portal actually allows for the user to access their portal on Stripe so they can manage their payment information and their purchases. Naturally, you have to have Stripe information. You can set the button change plan to whatever different page that you want. So ideally what you do is you set this to a redirect URL in the block settings for Stripe. So for example, you can go inside of Stripe, press activate link, and then it will look something like this. And that's what would be redirected to after they click on the link for change plan or open billing portal. So essentially inside of Softr, you're able to charge people, send them to their billing portal to make sure that they can change or cancel their subscriptions, change their details as well from a payment method standpoint, and go through everything everything needed from a billing standpoint using the amazing Stripe integration that we have. If you found this video useful, please make sure to hit that like button, subscribe, and check out other videos on our channel on how to use Softr even better. Thanks for watching.